find your people. So he goes, nah, we're not interested. So they leave. The angel said, come on, let's go. So they leave. As they're leaving, the lightning comes down and it burns the city down. And the angels say to Lot, don't look back. You're going to hear a lot of things and you're going to, you know, experience a lot of things, but don't look back. Well, of course, his wife couldn't help it. So she looked back, and so she turns into a pillar of salt. And then in the portrait, I show Lot with his kids, and there's the wife. She's still pointing. And the cities are nothing but rubble and smoke, you know. I mean, it's just, they're gone. And I guess she stays back there until the rain just wears her down to nothing. She just sort of dissolves, I guess.
Maybe
I don't
go
know.
And lick her.
Yeah. Maybe there's a bunch of cows out there that are licking. This is Jesus is condemned to death. This is where they were in mocking him and all that. And so at the first station, I did a complimentary painting of the prophets being stoned. Okay, so basically he is being condemned and the prophets are being condemned.
That's sad.
No, he's mad.
He's mad.
He's mad. Okay. This is right after Pilate had washed his hands of the thing. But I like parts about this, but I didn't like that. That took away from it. I thought.
Mm-hmm.
And the columns were just a lot of trouble to put on, so I decided not to do that. But this is a prototype of those out there. I also decided not to paint these in black and white. It took forever.
Well, let's go look at the station.
Okay. This is basically the same painting, except he's bruised. This is after he's been stripped and beaten, and here's the cattail that they used for his scepter. So this is after all that's been done, and they've redressed him and getting him ready to go and receive the cross. And underneath here is the Moses receiving the laws of man. So Moses receives the laws of man, and Jesus receives the laws of the Jews. Because the Jews said, you've been out healing people. You've been working on the Sabbath, which is against the law. And, of course, Pilate, and I'd heard this later on, Pilate really wanted Jesus to be saved because he thought Jesus would be a good ally as far as the Jews were concerned. I mean, he was the Savior, the Messiah, and all that. His wife, Pilate's wife, had dreams. They talk about that in the Bible, but actually what was going on is she was converting over to Christianity. Of course, Christianity and Judaism were very, very similar. I mean, they had the same rites and the same, everything was going on. But along with this, what I decided to do, besides adding a lot more sequins and adding this painting, I added the 22nd Psalm. The 22nd Psalm is a psalm that parallels real closely with what's gone on in the crucifixion. And see, it's here, it's talked off. He says, I'm but a worm and no man, a reproach of men and despised of the people. And that's the sixth verse of the 22nd Psalm. Now, all the way through this, now, the 22nd Psalm was written by David. Of course, it's in the Old Testament. And there's some things that happened in the 22nd Psalm that when I read it, I said, I can't believe this. You know, it parallels what's going on with the crucifixion. It talks about piercing my hands and feet, just all sorts of things, defiling me and all that. So, you know, I found that real interesting. And basically, what's happening to him is he is in the public and he is being ridiculed and basically stoned, just like Jeremiah and some of the earlier prophets. If they weren't stoned, they were threatened to be stoned. And the main reason that they did not, that they were stoned is because the people didn't want to hear what they had to say. The main reason that this man's being crucified is because he's saying things that these people don't want to hear. And it was not just the everyday Jew, that wanted him dead. It was not the Romans. The Romans could care less. It was the upper echelon in the temple that wanted him killed. Now, you'll see along in here, you'll see pictures of dogs. This dog represents mankind and his fidelity. So you'll see this throughout. In some places, the dog's licking the wounds. Other places, the dog is just watching, seeing what's going on. Other places, the dog just disappears. So this is where he receives the cross, and it says, "But be not far from me, for trouble is near, for there is none to help." And of course, this is from the St. Augustine prayer book. These are the prayers that are in there. As you go, you know what the Stations of the Cross
is.
Jesus falls three times under the cross. First time, he falls, and then down here a little further, he falls again. And then over here, he falls a third time. The first time that he falls is the first temptation from the devil, where the devil says, "Take one of these stones and turn it to bread." And Jesus says, "Man does not live by bread alone." And so...
I love that devil.
Yeah. I've actually got a sculpture of the devil similar to that.
Ooh.
One of those, about that size. And the name of it is Dressed to Kill. And this one says, "Deliver my soul from the sword, my darling from the power of the dog." And of course, here's the dog licking his hand again. And each time you'll notice, you look at his face and look at his hands and look at his robes, he gets worse and worse.
The details, beautiful.
And the further he goes down, the worse he gets. When he gets right to the end, you say, "I'm surprised this guy's even living."
Now, I have a question. You said you didn't like using the gold leaf because it took so long. Mm-hmm. How much longer did it take them doing the sequins? Because I think that would take a long time, too.
Well, now, these are interesting because these are the 12 flames of the Pentecost. And they also represent the apostles. The day of Pentecost is when the Holy Ghost visited.
Uh-huh.
And that's why you have Pentecostal churches, is because they believe the Holy Ghost comes and visits them, and they have flames or auras that come out of their head. I'm doing a painting on that now. It's gonna be a good one. But this is where he falls the first time. People in the background sort of, so what? They're just here sort of watching it because they want to see what's going on. Then he meets his mother. And in this, he's in the temple as a child. And his mother is peeking around the column here because she's not supposed to be in there. This is not a place for women. How she got in there, nobody really knows. But she's peeking around to seeing what's going on, and Jesus is in there teaching them. And it says here, "But thou art he who took me out of the womb. Thou didst make me hope when I was upon my mother's breast." And so there she is, and you just have to imagine how she feels seeing what's going on with her son. And he was more than her son. She knew who he was.